Hello. I've been thinking lately about some pieces that I was introduced to when I first started playing harpsichord. It's quite normal for these pieces to be shown to beginners. And I have made the mistake, perhaps, of thinking of them too much in that context. They're from a collection by François Couperin, 18th century French composer, called L'art de toucher le clavecin, or just the art of playing the harpsichord. And there were 8 preludes that he used to illustrate these pedagogical suggestions, prescriptions, principles that he laid down in the book. And they are in different musical styles and make different technical demands on the player. I knew one other thing about them, which is that they are legendary for making the instrument sound good. I was told, I remember by someone, if you want people to like the sound of your instrument, play one of the Couperin pieces. I'm going to play for you one of them, though, that when I picked it up recently, struck me as containing a great deal more in it than I had ever suspected. It's the very first one, in fact. It's a mere 50 seconds or so of C major. And it builds on an older tradition, exemplified, in fact, by François Couperin's uncle, Louis Couperin, who wrote preludes that were so free in their conception and in the liberties they allowed the player that they don't even have written note values. The rhythms are left up to the intuitions and perceptions of the player. So, in fact, they sort of counterfeited free improvisation, but that did provide the pitches so that the player didn't have to know it all. The prelude I'm going to play for you, the teeny little prelude of concentrated musical wisdom, is made up almost entirely of eighth notes, but they seek to incarnate that old tradition, which was in fact adapted from the Italians in the first place, so that the player has freedom to interpret when notes should be played. Now, the surprise for me when I, in my new wisdom, picking this up, was how contrapuntal are the structures that he's built into these evidently undifferentiated eighth notes. They look like this. And in fact, the way I perceived this was, after playing it through, I was walking up 6th Avenue, and it was going through my head, and that's when I heard how profound the contrapuntal interaction was. So sometimes it's good to get away from your keyboard and think about the music that way. Let me play it for you now and see what you think. So not only does it, I think, make my little Italian-style harpsichord sound pretty good, but it gives me, the performer, or you, the performer, if you play it, freedom that we don't have in all music, and it also has hidden within it a perfectly constructed miniature piece of some considerable learning and profundity. In the next episode, I will introduce you to a totally different prelude from this collection, that illustrates totally different style and calls for different technical devices from the player.